हेलो फ्रेंड्स, स्टैंडर्ड 10 सब्जेक्ट मैथ्स, दिस इज द वीडियो 3 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 10 दैट इज सर्कल। व्हाट वी डिड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर, वी लर्न द थ्योरम 10.1, अ टेंजेंट ड्रॉन टू एनी पॉइंट ऑफ अ सर्कल टू द रेडियस ऑफ पॉइंट ऑफ कांटेक्ट इज ऑलवेज शॉर्टेस्ट डिस्टेंस। देन वी लर्न द एंड वी डिड द सम विद द हेल्प ऑफ द पाइथागोरस थ्योरम। वी ड्रॉ the one circle, in that circle we have drawn one tangent, according to tangent the point which is outside, and we draw such kind of the sums we have been trying to do. Point of contact, and we complete the our sum, because we know that the theorem 10.1 tells us that the point of contact, that is always the shortest distance, that we did in our previous two videos. Now today the topic is a number of tangents from a point of circle. There are three cases. These you must have to remember, because this is going to be asked in 1 month. Case 1, point lying inside the circle. It means that if the point, this is center of circle, point lying inside the circle, so while you draw it, what happening? Then we did in the theorem 10.1, it is becoming going to be a become a second. It is not tangent. So here we can write, we not get tangent. We are not getting tangent over here. Not a single reason we are able to get over here. Case 2, point lying on a circle. Point lying on a circle means you have to draw a circle. This is point. This is your center. Then already you know that the point of contact. So we are able to get 1 tangent in this situation. Tangent touch always one and only one point of a circle. This situation is a on circle means one point on a circle. This question may be arise in your mind, sir. How many tangents you are getting in circle? In circle, infinitely many points are there. So we are getting number of tangents. But tangents only touch one and only one point of a circle. But how many tangents you are getting? You are getting infinitely many tangents on a circle. Now the third condition is that this you have to just forget it. This is not going to be helpful to you. This I have to speak up of it. So I am just going to write this. Point lying outside the circle. This is interesting one. And this only it's going to be helpful to me. The point outside the circle. This one is your center. What happening? You are able to draw this point of contact, one tangent. This is another point of contact, that is secondary. Okay. Right. How many tangents we are able to get when the point outside the circle? We are able to get the two tangents. We are able to get the two tangents when point is outside the circle. When point on a circle, we are able to get one tangent, and when point is inside, we are able to get the second. So not a single tangent we are getting over here. This is really helpful to me. This looks like a peak of any bird. With the help of this, now we are just going to be learn theorem 10.2. When we are taking any point outside the circle and when we draw it, these both are going to become in same in size. PQ is equal to PR. Then we are just going to be a do in theorem 10.2. From theorem 10.2, the length of tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal. Already that condition I have shown in that figure to you. Now we are going to write in theorem. Always remember, you must have to write first given. You must have to write first given. With the help of this statement, we are able to write a circle with center O and of point P external. A point P is external to the circle. While you join P to circle, two tangents, PQ and PR, will be kept from A. A circle with center O, very simple. Here it is written the length of the tangent drawn from a circle, drawn from an external point. So here we mentioned a circle with the center O and a point which is external, a point P, external to the circle, while you join P to the circle with the two tangents. While you join P to the circle with the two tangents, PQ and PR, we get from it. Because P is outside from the circle. What are you going to do? To prove that both tangents are same in measure. So you are going to be like, PQ is equal to PR. For that, I am just going to draw the figure for yourself. That is, figure is really simple for you. We already discussed. This is O, point P outside the circle. This will go here.
So here you are getting
this is a magnetic ring. So it's a right hand side. You can prove this is the way the half of these two sides are equal. So here I'm going to write that triangle OQB is equal to triangle ORP by RHS congruency. By RHS congruency. How RHS congruency? You can just prove this is a 90 degree and these two sides are the equal. So with the help of RHS congruency, you just prove that this one is a these both triangles are congruent. These both triangles are congruent. So at the end, very simple, in the ninth channel you learn that by simplicity, you can just tell that KPQ is equal to PR. By simplicity, you are able to prove that PQ is equal to PR. But what is actually PQ and what is PR? They both are the tangent. They both are the tangent. And tangents are same in measure. And tangents are same in measure. Hence, prove. You are at last, you can just write. Hence, you prove. What you want to prove that the length of the tangent PQ and the length of the tangent PR are equal. Once again, we will just go through what is given in the question to us. The length of the tangents drawn from an axial point to a circle are equal, given. Don't worry about it. You can write it yourself. A circle with the center O and a point P is external to the circle. While we join P to the circle, circles, two tangents we are getting, PQ and PR, we get from it. To prove PQ is equal to PR, PQ is equal to PR. Figure we just joined with O is the center, then Q is the point of contact and R is the point of contact. We are getting two tangents when the any point external to the circle. So proof, join O to P, we get OP. Join O to Q, we get OQ. Join O to R, we are getting OR. We can just say that angle OQP is equal to angle ORP, that is equal to 90 degree by theorem 10.1. By theorem 10.1. Here you can see that OQ is equal to OR, radius of the same circle, and OP is equal to OB, that is a common side in this given triangle. So two triangles, you have simply proved that triangle OQP is equal to triangle ORP. By simplicity, you are able to just tell that okay, PQ is equal to PR. PQ is equal to PR. Length of the tangents are going to become the same one. Here the theorem 10.2 is completed. Afterwards, this one is most important for the objective, maybe MCQ. Whatever that is going to be asked from this, that you must have to remember. Tangents to the point of contact of two circles. Here, D do not stand for the diameter. D stands for its distance. D stands for its distance. Here, D is greater than R1 plus R2. In this condition, the two circles are different. And we are getting how many common tangents from it that you must have to remember. Oh, sorry. Here you must have to take care of yourselves. This one is 1. This one is 2. Here you must have to remember this touch over here. So here 1 tangent, 2nd tangent, 3rd tangent, and here it is a 4th tangent. How many tangents are you able to get? 1, 2, 3, 4. Then number of the common tangent is 4. Number of the common tangent is 4. Obviously, you are able to just get it. The distance between the this O to C is obviously greater. Now, D is equal to R1 plus R2. In this condition, what happened? These two circles join at one point or intersecting at one point. So it's simple. That's why it's becoming O and C. This one is your R1 and R2. Simple. Now, here you can take R1 and R2. Same. Now, what happening over here? How many common tangent you are able to get? So, first you will draw a common tangent which is passed from over here. This is the number 1. Very simple one. Here, just drawing. Just understand, but here I am not able to draw a perfect figure. This way, the tangent is going here and there, but you are getting exactly 3 tangents. How many tangents you are getting? Exactly 3 tangents. You are getting how much tangent over here? 3 tangents. Now, we must have to go for the third condition. That is, now in this condition, R1 minus R2, that is the identity modulus, less than the distance less than R1 plus R2. Over here, the circle is in this form. They intersect at a 2 point. They intersect at a 2 point. Now, what happened? How many tangents you are able to get? Very simple one. 1 and here 2. How many tangents we are getting? 2 tangents we are getting in such kind of the condition. Now, D is equal to R1 minus R2. It means one circle is there and another circle is just exactly touch to the second circle. So over here C is A, over here R is A. So R1 is bigger and R2 is smaller. R1 is bigger and R2 is smaller. You are able to get it. So here, how many tangent you are able to get? Tangent touch only and only one point of circle. That is, that's why we are able to get over here one tangent. We are able to get over here one tangent. This condition is really nice. B less than R1 minus R2. So here the circle's condition is like this one. Somewhere over here, this one is C, this one is O. So we are not getting C. This circle are not going to intersect somewhere else. Here in one point, so we are able to get one. So we are getting no tangent. Here we are getting no tangent. So this 5 condition you understood properly. With the help of this one kind of the one mark question we are able to get. Now one question that I am going to explain, that is about the angle. Last sum, and with the help of this you are able to just continue in your worksheet. This kind of the angle you are able to find with the help of this sum. PP and PQ are the two tangents to a circle with center O. So that angle POQ is equal to 110. Then you have to find the angle PPQ. So in geometry you must have to draw first figure. What is it? Its center is O. Center is O. Now what is outside? Outside is T. Now, this one is P and this one is Q. According to the theorem 10.1, okay, what is here? First of all, they have mentioned that here POQ. So, this angle they give us 110. This angle they have given us 110. Now, we are able to see, okay, we are able to get the 4 angles. How many angles they are getting? 4 angles. This one, according to the theorem 10.1, it is on 90. According to the theorem 10.1, this is also 90. In theorem 10.2, we just take as a 90 the common angle. So now the one angle is going to be made, that is, you have to write angle PTQ. Simple one. So angle P plus angle O plus angle Q plus angle T is equal to 360 degree. Is equal to 360. Angle P, you are going to take 90. Angle O, you are going to take 110. Angle Q, you are going to take 90. And plus angle T is equal to 360. So 90 plus 90, 180 plus 110 plus angle T is equal to 360. So 180, 110, 0, 9, 290 plus angle P is equal to 360. So angle P is equal to 360 minus 290, that is exactly 70, So you are able to write angle PTQ is equal to 70 degrees. Angle PTQ is equal to 70 degrees. Such kind of the angle sums you are, they can change the OEM, they will ask. They will divide this figure in this way. Like this way. In question they have given POT is equal to maybe 40. Then you have to find the PTO. Simple. This one is 90. One angle 40 is given. So you are able to find this angle. So it is simpler for yourself. Once you understand these angles addition, you are getting 360. So it is easy for yourself. So in worksheet such kind of the sums are there. And please prepare theorem 10.2. Thank you.